Greetings, and thank you for coming to support us by watching today's video. If you would like to support us even more, you can do so by clicking on the like button, posting a comment down below, and of course, if you would like to see more videos like this, make sure to click that subscribe button. Okay, so let's now go back to the Crystal Tower. Yeah, all the way up there. So much ground we've covered. Yeah, they're of course gonna load us in at the bottom. But we want to use the red crystal to take us back to the top. We have to figure out how to unlock each of these keys and the portals that hold them. Cause yeah, we're not allowed to examine these. We're not allowed to examine these. We have to use the portals. But the thing is, we don't know how and in what way. I used the green one at the end of last week, and I wasn't really sure where to go from there. Let's take the blue one this time. Okay, where are we currently? Chamber of Fire and Water. So, let's go ahead and start going down, I guess, because it's our only option by the looks of it. So yeah, it looks like the green and the blue crystals will take us to ultimately where we need to go. So let's start fighting stuff.
Alrighty, let's go!
Oh, hello there. You're new. What are you susceptible to there, sea worm? We will find out soon enough. Rest assured. Alright, so water golem's gone. Now we have to try and make you unstable. Let's see if we can do that. Now you resist fire. Do I have anything that can hit you? Well, I do have Tremor, but it's gonna cost me half my AP. Yeah, it could take quite a bit of effort to get you unstable. Okay. Can you use Red Fang? Can you use Water? Okay, so as it stands right now, I'm better off. I'm just fine with using Red Fang, even though I know it'll be resistance. It's really my only option. Because, yeah, I'm giving up my abilities to make things unstable in the pursuit of trying to get stuff beaten. Oh, ho, ho, ha, ha. Okay, Red Fang you again. Oh, you're red, and you're down, okay. So now let's finish off the water golem. Alright, you're gone. Now, what are you susceptible to for imprisoning? We have to... Okay, just weaken him. He's completely weak to thunder. Which is kind of what I thought. Alright, so I guess at some point he'll be susceptible. But I think it needs to be, within the context of just him on his own. Oh, nope, we can make the move. Why have I been slowed down? No matter, let's try and imprison it. Ah, couldn't get it. Rain, give it a shot. Nope, still no. Like, it's right on the cusp. I'm afraid of attacking it again. I'm really afraid of attacking it again. Oh, I thought I had it that time!
Go!
Try it again. Oh, he's just not giving in. And he countered me. Alright, I don't really have much of a choice, do I? If I don't get it here, I will unstack. Yeah, okay. So yeah, I don't have a choice but to unstack here. And take the very risky attempt of attacking it. Okay, he's still standing.
Now don't move.
Still refusing. Defend. You defend too, because the only person I trust to make an attack is Tama. It's not her turn. Rain, you can try and imprison again.
No!
But yeah, I feel like it's right on the cusp. Just being... Oh, and then it flees! Son of a bitch. Well, that was unfortunate. Yeah, so many attempts ultimately ends in failure, not by us killing it, but by the stupid thing running away. How heartbreaking. Okay, so going this way, I suppose. Across the bridge. And we are all stacked up again.
We got this.
Oh, whoa. Well, you're new. What's not new is the bomb. Yeah, we've seen bombs before. See, let's just get rid of the bombs first. But Ghidra, you're different. You are a new face and you have my interest. Oh. Yeah, so much countering. And missing, too. Let's pursue you. Almost got you dead. Alright, you're down. Zero damage because I'm riding the red dragon. Oh, but then you self-destructed! Ow. Yeah, stupid thing. Stupid bomb. Go down! Now, how do we go about imprisoning a Ghidra? Or is it a Ghidra? I really don't know. Just weaken it, alright? Just weaken it. Well, at least we know that on paper, these enemies will be easier to put into a position to imprison. I don't need to do anything special other than just weaken them. I outran you. Ooh, Mage Masher. That's hurt. Alright, he's susceptible. See if we can do it. On the first try, we got a Ghidra. Success.
We did it.
Victory.
Yeah, put that one in the bank. And that got us another 46,000 experience points. And Titan keeps gaining levels, of course. So, we got ourselves a Ghidra, the enhanced version of a Bi-Hydra. A dragon-like mirage with three heads, each of which spits a different type of flame. Its name is not, in fact, short for Greg the Huge Industrially Designed Roasting Apparatus. But you can call it Greg if you want. Somebody break out the marshmallows! Greg's here! For some reason. Alright. And it's a large, so we're not going to take it with us right now. We're going to leave it with Seraphie. If we have to come back and get it later, we will. But for now, I'm fine. Alright, resuming descent. Yeah, that's crazy the way I have to do this over and over again. Cause yeah, who knows how far we really have to go. I know these are separate portals to separate places, but I can't help but wonder how long it would take us to try and get to where we need to go. Okay, so first things first, eliminate the water golem. Okay, now we have to start the process again. Its abilities, Tremor. Going. Haha, Blaze Spikes. Abilities. Red Fang. Resisted. Tremor again. Alright, starting to get you shook up. Alright, well, Terra, but it's not that bad. Red Fang. Oh, we don't have you over the top yet. Uh-oh. Well, we do now. Yeah, there we go. Alright. Rain, eliminate the water golem, please. There we go. Now we just have you. How far do we have to push? Whoa, that was a crit hit. I mean, it's right there. It's right on the cusp. Can we actually get one this time? Yes! This time, we get success. Yes, we get success. And we got ourselves a sea worm. That's another 24,000 experience points in the bank. As we get our hands on this large sea worm, a marine menace that lurks near Grimoire's shores. Some say that it looks as graceful as an angel when it swims, but we prefer to describe it as a nightmarish shock puppet with teeth. Also, cancel this thing's gym membership right now. Oh, because it has such a muscular build? Yeah, I can understand why. Default looks good, and we're not taking it with us, so leave it with Seraphie. Alright, so we got ourselves a sea worm at long last. Well, I say long last, but it did take us two tries to get there. Yeah, who knows how long this path is. Because yeah, as you can see, it's branching off now.
I won't hold back.
Well, we don't have to worry about going after these things, because we have the stuff already. And retaliation with Blaze Spikes. Well, I guess the best interest would be for us to go after the bomb. Man, Lon taking a beating here. We need to let my HP, or rather my AP, recharge. That's just all there is to it. Okay, resisting fire. Ooh, nice crit hit for the win. Good job there, Rain. And Lon, you too! Alright, I'm back at full. So, a little beating for Lon. Take this. Load it up. And go after it. Nice crit hit. Haha. Two attacks that you sent after rain both score zero damage. That's music to my ears. And a delight to my eyes. And it happened three times in a row. Oh, that time though, Lon did take damage. Haha, retaliation. Yeah, now the retaliation comes your way, fool. Yeah, there's the score for ya. Keep putting it in the bank. Okay, yeah, now I'm curious. I have to see what's over here. If anything. Is there really nothing over here? Oh, that was kind of pointless. But we had to be sure. Had to know exactly what we were dealing with. Next. Okay. Well, we don't have to worry about imprisoning this group of bows. Let's eliminate the water golem. And now we'll smash the sea worm and his friend. Well, you do have good resistance there. I guess that because of your combination of defense and whatnot. We can wear you down. It's not that bad. Okay, Rain, I will play it safe here and have you heal yourself. And Lon, attack. Let's take our time with this. It's not that hard of a boss. Actually, it's not really a boss, but it just gives you the impression of one because it has such high defense because it's a stack. Oh, we actually got to the point where it's getting shaky. Well, we have been hitting on it for quite a while. And that's not something you typically see with an enemy stack. Ow, that was a bad miss. Oh, we got him shaken now. But will he die first? I think it's more likely he'll die first.
No trouble at all.
Oh, wait!
Here we go. So yeah, we can do it even without having to unstack him. Alright, continuing descent. What are we getting towards? A save point? Oh, it's because of what's over here. Okay, so we've reached the boss, I guess, of this side. Alright, so over on the right is an adversary that we have to destroy. So now we got to deal with that. Yeah, as far as the map is concerned, like, and truth be told, we didn't even have to go that far. It was just four sections. Actually, it was looks like even more than that. It looks like eight sections, maybe, or even more than that. Alright. Well, we know that this boss is here, and he's not alone. He has a giant Ahriman for a friend. Alright. Oh, is this a fight against him, or is this something else? Nope. One last line of defense. Crap. I guess we better go back to the save points then after this fight. Well, good job on the crit hits, guys. Good job with those crit hits. Like this. 1200 points. And then that'll tip you over. Now we got you to deal with. Take that. Swordbreaker doesn't score. You're down. Now it's just you, Gaidra. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna call you from now on, is just Gaidra. It just makes sense. And we keep hitting you with Blaze Spikes, dude. Oh, but then you do the same to us. But it scores no damage on us. So yeah, sucks to be you. Yeah, even when sent against me, it hardly scores. Oh, thought we had you dead there. But we do now.
That was a good fight.
Alright. Need more levels. Alright. Yeah. Right before I'm about to fight you guys. Okay, I'm satisfied. Run back over quickly before another enemy fight.
Get ready! Yeah. They're coming this way!
Now it's on. Against this scary Ahriman and his friend.
Is this the keeper of the waterlock?
You fools! These dark depths shall be your tomb!
Tama, you okay?
Oh,
yeah.
It just looked like he the wanted to say as much. That's all.
What?
Yeah, I don't know what's going on there, but we have a Kraken and a Bure. Alright, it's the Bure that makes me worry more. Primarily because I'm quite sure he could inflict confusion on me if he wanted to. Alright, 1143 is a good start on damage. Oh, you have Reflect. Well, not that I cast much in terms of magic anyway, and thankfully, Faraga hardly does anything. And thanks to the red dragon on one stack, it does zero damage for Lorraine. So yeah, puts the viewer behind the ball somewhat. Up then we get Waterga from the Kraken, of course. Yeah, we're wearing down the viewer, no problem. In fact, we even outran him. Cursed Gaze, okay, this is what I was worried about. But it does not look like I suffered from confusion. Okay, I'm going to heal myself this turn.
This is it!
Okay, Rain, go after him again. I want to keep going. I want to finish off the Bure before we... Oh, crap. Well, now I have no choice but to open my eyes. Since I know Lon's turn out to come soon, we'll help him out first. Oh, and they're both poisoned. Oh, crap. And now they're both poisoned. Oh, crit hit. He's not dead yet, though. Well, Rain, you have to heal yourself this turn. There is no choice. Oh, magic counter, yeah. Alright, just finish him off. But he's down. But I get this on me again. Curing.
I've got it.
Okay, Lon, you have to use an antidote. Yeah, I'm glad I accumulated all these status of recovery items before I began this fight. I would rather you heal first there, Rain. Before you start taking stuff off of yourself. Okay, no point in you casting Reflect. Alright, at the very least, we need to use an antidote. And the blind is off, so we're fine in that regard. So now we can go on offense. Except for Lon, who has to heal himself this round. Alright, let loose. Terga actually hurts quite a bit on Rain's stack. So yeah, she'll have to heal herself here.
I've got this.
In fact, I probably should be using thunder spells on this guy. I have some in my collection, do I not? I do. How much can I damage you for? Actually, it's how much am I going to damage myself for? I forgot he cast Reflect on himself. And I have nothing that takes that off. Yeah, I kind of messed up. Yeah, that was definitely a waste of a thunder spell, sadly. Sadly, that was a waste of a thunder spell. Like this. And now he's just content to cast Reflect on himself repeatedly. Which, quite frankly, I don't mind. He can do that as much as he wants. I'll still run circles around him. I think he's surrendered. Because he knows we're gonna win. So he's just casting Reflect on himself over and over again. He knows we're about to beat him down into the dust. Wow, he doesn't attack for his last 6 turns.
No trouble at all.
Predictable.
Wow. He had Waterga, he could have used it, but instead he just used Reflect for the last 6 turns. Yeah, if that's not a declaration of surrender, I don't know what is. So we got another 8 Arma Gems, 2 Spellstones for both Water and Fire, as well as a Kraken and Bure Memento. I know what the Bure Memento can be used for. I have a pretty good idea. Oh, and so we get sent right back here.
That took the care of 2 of the locks at once!
Oh, nice!
Alright.
Since we beat 2 Mirages, we just need 1 more pair.
And they're gonna be on the other side. Oh, we know what that means. Let's go over to the save point. Because we definitely need it.